Now we begin. And indeed, greetings unto you, beloved and holy friends. I come forth to abide with you in this manner and in this way for a specific reason, which will become clear as we continue. But rest assured, I am not apart from you in any moment, wherever you are. The only thing that can separate you from me is your choice to think a thought on my love. I am your brother and your friend, and I look upon you and I see only myself. I see only that which the Father has given birth unto, like the Father gave birth to me, and for the very same purpose. I come forth then to abide with you through this body-mind of my beloved brother, who once again has allowed me to use it for a short while. I come forth to abide with you, that certain words will be recorded. They shall come to be important in the passage of time. It is not by accident, then, that you are here. Rest assured, you have not come on a whim. Interesting word you have, whim. You have come because we have asked you to be here. And when I speak of we, I speak of myself. I speak of my brother, Germain. I speak of my, those who would call her such as my mother, Mary. My beloved friend, heart sister, lover divine, friend, teacher, Mary Magdalene, and all beings who comprise that of those beings engaged in this great work of the atonement of mankind. Rest assured, I am in charge of the atonement. We have called to each and every one of you individually, depth of your prayer and your meditation and in the silence between your thoughts, and ask you to come to this room, to this hour, to this time. Take a look around through your physical eyes and let them see the physical bodies of your brothers and sisters. For well do we say unto you, there is no one in this room who is just meeting for the first time. There is no one in this room that has not participated in other time frames, other worlds, other dimensions. But specifically, we speak of lifetimes in this world of yours that have not already been connected to this lineage. This is why for many of you, when you became aware of this lineage in any of its various forms, you felt as though you had come home. Know you the feeling? How can it feel like home? Already know it. So rest assured, as you look around this circle, everyone is here by specific invitation. Everyone has agreed to be here. And I come forth in this hour because I ask of you, I implore of you, drop the curtain of doubt.
Okay.
You are part of an ancient family. A family is made of friends who have chosen to incarnate, to take on the dream of separation in order to go through the alchemy of healing that dream in your own being, thus to do the same thing that I did, that Germain has done, that we have all done before. You have entered into physical form to forget God, to feel. feel the weight of unworthiness, to know the weight of doubt, to take on the burden of guilt and shame and smallness, to be distracted by the things of the world, so that you know and understand the burden that has trapped your brothers and your sisters. Let me say this again. You, each and every one of you, are not here because you failed on this planet. It is time for you to come to understand that it is your compassion and it is the love of the Christ you are that called you to this planet in the first place. You have taken on sins of the world, the dream of separation, to know and understand the frequencies that bind this planet, that bind humanity, so that it can be set free. Perhaps it is seen like the school that you entered lasted a bit too long. But this is not possible. We have invited you here to come together, to heal together, to celebrate together, to feel the resonance. And please don't pretend that you didn't notice the resonance of this group in your first gathering. You all know each other. All of you know at the level of soul that it has not been by accident that you have incarnated into this time frame, family structure that you find yourself in. And as you have come together, though you seem to think you're looking at bodies and perhaps are distracted by the thoughts of the lesser self, the deep soul has felt the resonance that has reminded you of what you know. Is this not true? So you see, like attracts like. We've invited you to activate this sleeping memory. No, it hasn't been asleep in all of you. Some of you are awakened to this great truth. But some of you, it's been sleeping a bit. You've heard it whispered to you. You've touched it. But now in the presence of your brothers and sisters, can you any longer doubt what you know? You have taken on the sins of the world in order to demonstrate that you know how to heal it. There is another purpose. You are part of a grand orchestration that began a long time ago. It was decided not by someone apart from you, but in conjunction with you, that you would incarnate into this time frame of the world just as it is, and that you would complete your journey through the various frequencies of guilt, shame, smallness, separation, in order to know their pain so profoundly that as you allow healing to come, no one who will be sent to you will be able to mistake the truth that love is. come back to that statement again. That no one who will be sent to you.
We ask you then in this hour to come to see
are the great masters. You are the ones we come to serve. We come to help you do the work that you have chosen. For some of you, this may be a slight reversal of how you think. Rest assured, it has been necessary for us to come as your friends and brothers to let you see us as great masters, because you are at some stage of taking on the sins of the world, experiencing yourself as small and lost and incapable. And so, yes, we have appeared and brought forth great light and uplifted you and brought miracles to bear. We have not forgotten the master plan. To each and every one of you, we have come to you precisely in the moment decreed by you before you took birth in this life. Not a moment before. Tonight marks a great turning point. The great question will remain, will you allow the turning to complete itself in you?
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
How then to allow this great turning, this turning of the age, in which you come to see, by the way, this does not make you special. It makes you the fulfillment of the servant of God. And you are the servant's extraordinaire. You are the ones that experience it. Which you simply walk down the street and you are bombarded by the frequencies of pain, the frequencies of guilt, the vibrations of heaviness and doubt. Know any of those feelings?
Yes.
Yeah.
You go to what you call the coffee shop and you suddenly feel heaviness in your auric field. You don't know where it came from. You are the ones that have chosen to incarnate in a physical form that shares the vibrational field of all of humanity. This means that where the body is that you once mistakenly called me, or I, is ceaselessly and constantly enmeshed, if you will, engaged in the vibrational frequencies of all of humanity. Humanity lives in every cell of your body. Take a breath. But well did I notice a thought in a few of you, this sounds like a burden. It is not a burden, it is a blessing. Thank God that humanity is in the nucleus of every cell. Do you need to travel to the ends of the earth to help heal humanity? Well, your body may travel to the ends of the earth if the Father sends you. But the point we want you to understand, to take deeply into your being, to know profoundly that in every single moment you can breathe light into humanity. To every being and every body and every man and every woman and every child, they live in you. precious then is there a moment to be right where you are, to recognize that your body encompasses and carries the life of every being and every physical form, every body that has come to take on certain vibrational patterns. And there are certain beings that haven't got a clue how to breathe light into the nucleus of their cells. You can do it for them. And rest assured, when you simply remember the truth of who you are and why you have come, and breathe that light and those frequencies, and you allow us and you call to us to join with you at any given moment, you don't have to go to a temple, you don't need to sit on your meditation cushion, you can go to your coffee shop for a whole new reason. Wherever you are, now is the time. The turning of the age is upon us. Looking forward.
Yes.
Well, forward is now here. Your brothers and sisters wait for you to be the one who recognizes there is no purpose to time save the healing. It's time to give up seeking to heal your wounds. For if you would well receive it from this moment, it is finished. But it is not finished. For your brothers and sisters. It is time now to recognize that you no longer need to seek for answers, to find an understanding of what has occurred in the past. The past is gone.
Yes! Yes.
You are here for the purpose for which you were birthed in the holy mind of God. You are here because you chose, many, many lifetimes ago, to use that language, to take on the sins of the world, to join with those masters who had awakened, to find out what it means to embody Christ. You are here, and the time is now at hand to be that one who joyously utilizes every moment to breathe that light and that love into the heart and soul of every human soul upon this planet. By remembering that your very bodies hold all beings in the very nucleus of the cells of the form given unto you. And thus, to give yourself over to the breathing of that light, to transmit that light, that frequency, that joy. How do you do that? Well, it's quite complicated. You just do it. You merely choose. This is how we would ask that you do this. Anytime you want, just pause and ask yourself, as the arisen Christ, what divine frequency would I love to transmit to you? You will know immediately, and some of you already do this, but you will, all of you will be coming to see these frequencies, for every frequency of energy has its own color, its own quality to it. Magentas and blues and violets and oranges and reds and all of the rest and subtle nuances thereof. For thought, for love, for frequency is energy itself. As you ask this simple question, will see it immediately. It may come as a word, faith. Have you seen the frequency of faith? Simply begin to make your home in the breathing and simply allow the frequency of faith into every cell of your being as you, what you'd be calling the exhalation, see that frequency of faith flowing forth into every cell of your being and through the nucleus of the cells of your body, entering into the matrix, the subtle matrix from which the body is emerging that makes up all human beings. Simple, isn't it? It is time for you to simply rest in the heart of your being and your truth and your knowingness, to know that the past has passed away. This is why I've come. I've always known I had a purpose. I've been waiting. Tonight is what you've been waiting for. It is simply time for you to take up your rightful place. It is time for all of you to honor each other by doing this often in remembrance of the truth of the oneness. Though your bodies will be separate in space and time, in fact, we would remind you that try as you might, you have never been able to get two bodies to occupy the same space. Well, do we recognize the great enjoyment you have had trying? Thank you. may sound odd to you, when was the last time you prayed love with a feeling? Does that thought seem surprising to you? What is a building but consciousness? Is it not an out-picturing of what consciousness would wish to see? Is there a molecule somewhere in creation that is not worthy of the light of love? Try it. Tonight, when you go to your rooms, hold the image of what you call the Croydon Hall. Seems to have more than one hall. I don't know why they don't call it Croydon Halls. We find great humor with your language. Sit in your room and feel the walls. Do you know that they carry the vibration of everybody that's ever been in those rooms? That can be quite a weight.
Yes.
Help the walls heal.
Okay.
Why not? You are surrounded by your beautiful Mother Earth. The trees here are around the place that you have chosen to gather. Oh, do you have any idea the role trees play? Maintaining the frequency balance in the human energetic field. I'm not speaking just of sunlight and earth and water and all of the rest. They absorb frequencies and transmute frequencies. When was the last time you loved a tree with a dove of light through you? So you see, from this hour, you no longer have time to waste on trying to heal. Now is the time come to seize time, to be the light givers. There is no one in this room does not know intimately and fully every subtle nuance of the pain of separation. Guilt, doubt, fear, and all the rest. Do these things sound familiar to you? You know them inside and out, and once again we would share with you, you came to know them inside and out because of your compassion, your willingness to join with us, to come to this particular dimension of creation, of which there are an infinite number, to heal, to transfigure the dream of separation into the reality of heaven on earth. That is why you are here. Will you allow this great turning to complete itself in you?
Yes.
Yes.
You see, though you have come to us many times as great masters, some of you have come to us so many times that we have lost count. Asking us to heal you. Well, going along with your own plan, we said, okay. And we emanated the frequencies of light and healing and suggestions and all of the rest to you, waiting patiently for you to recognize that the very reason you were doing that was so that you could understand the need to seek healing outside oneself. And the subtle nuances of the exchange of energies between you as the seeker and the one who is providing the frequency. All of the subtle nuances involved, and the most important thing of all, is that no one heals another. I have never healed anyone. I have emanated the light of God to many. But you have needed to understand the mechanism of receiving, the willingness to allow that light to penetrate your being. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
For many will be sent to you who will not yet understand that they are the source of all power under heaven. Ask you to transmit the frequencies of light to them. So just do it.
Okay.
Okay.
And wait for them to awaken to the truth. He finally sees, my God, Jeshua can come and stand in my midst and emanate the perfect light of God, but he is powerless if I do not offer willingness to be penetrated. This is always true, because if it were not true, it would mean you are not a sovereign being. It would mean that I could override your desire. No one can override the desire of what God has created and given freedom to dream the dream they wish to dream. No one can override that. We can simply demonstrate that you might want to consider a new choice. We can emanate the frequencies of light and joy and celebration and peace and extraordinary play with the frequencies of the universe so that hopefully it will catch your attention. You and you alone now know that nothing changes until you want it to change. Therefore, beloved friends, to allow this great turning to complete itself in you will require that you want it to, that you feel the desire of it constantly, that you play in the frequencies of extending this light by breathing it into you as we've described, seeing and feeling it enter into the subtle matrix of all of humanity. And rest assured, all you need do is sit in your coffee shop or wherever you wish to be and simply begin that process. And just ask. If you want to ask us, we'll be there to help you. Jermaine, you're my brother, my friend, my teacher. You're the one I resonate with. Mary, it doesn't matter who it is. We don't get jealous. And we don't keep count. Well, okay, Jermaine and I do keep count. He likes to remind me that he's winning. I let him believe what he wants. We have fun. Rest assured, if you call on us, you're free to do that. Jermaine, Jeshua, Mary, who would you bring before me right now? And that fast, someone will come. They may be someone who appears to you and right away go, wait a minute. What they're wearing went out of style 6,000 years ago. It's because an aspect of their soul has been stuck there. There's something unhealed, incomplete of that time frame or that lifetime. That's why you'll see them as they appear to you. That's literally the time frame or who and what they were at the time when something got glitched. The wire got snapped. So let it come. Changed, by the way, some will be sent to you and you won't recognize what they're wearing because it hasn't shown up yet on the planet. Healing is not just in the past. So, when they are sent unto you, just let them come. You'll see them immediately. And just, again, ask, what frequency would I most desire to send to this beautiful soul? Because you see, as you ask that question, you as Christ cannot help but automatically desire the one frequency they most need. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Christ does not deliver junk mail. Christ does not deliver what's unworkable and what's not needed. Christ is the frequency, is the oneness of knowingness, that oneness with God itself that already knows. And you access that frequency through the purity of your desire. But love, extend light to another. You don't have to have a single idea, thank God. Merely desire, what frequency would I most desire as Christ to send to the heart of this beautiful being? Be right there. It may suddenly be the power of a will to step forward and complete their task. Breathe it into your being, radiate it into the subtle matrix of their being, and it will suffuse their nucleus. Now is the time to start sneaking in the back door. The only question remains, will you allow this great turning to complete itself in you?
Yes.
Yes.
Some of you are thinking, didn't he already ask us that?
Yeah.
Those of you that know us well, you probably have learned, if we repeat ourselves, there might be a reason.
It's very different.
Beloved friends, long has been the journey, yet only the twinkling of an eye. From this day and hour, let it be known, deep in your being, to whoever you want to share it with, that that which has been known as the germane, how germane can that be? Germane is germane to the process of healing. Though I have never allowed myself to call him a saint. I've known him for a long time. He's no saint. There's far too much of a mischievous twinkle in the eyes of his heart to ever become a saint. Far beyond any such categorization. On the other hand, he's never called me the savior of the world. He's known me way too long. We are brothers and friends. We are in perfect communion and communication always in the great frequency of what I have used in this pathway to call friendship. A friend is one who deliberately gives the whole of their being to seeing you only as the light of Christ itself, and holds you in that frequency for all eternity. That is the meaning of a friend. Our friendship is quite profound. And because we hold each other in that light, because we have joined in friendship in that light, we create ceaselessly together in many dimensions beyond this one. Yet what we create there is the same as what we create here. Contexts, teachings, opportunities, frequencies that invite the sleeping to awaken. This is our great delight. It is our great delight because you are a great love. Tonight, it's time to give up thinking that you still have a journey or a distance to travel to join us. It is time to recognize that this is the night, the day, the hour, the moment in which you have asked us to come and let you know, to deliver the telegram and ask you to open it. It is written by your own hand. Now is the time upon the earth that has been prayed for and waited for and worked for. And you have been a profound participant in the necessary work of entering into the matrix of separation that you would know it inside and out. For many will be sent to you, and from this day and hour, regardless of what they think, regardless of what they say, regardless of their defense mechanisms, look them in the eyes you radiate whatever frequency you want to them, and tell them the truth. Brother and sister, you are the one worthy of all the love of God right here and right now. And I am here because I love you. And in your voice they will know that it is true. Only because you have entered into the dream of separation, you have taken it on and felt it all, and thus you speak with the authority of one who knows. Isn't that what you've always liked about us? Jermaine knew the depths of separation. He knows what those frequencies are all about. He knows that the frequencies are like to heal that and then extend that which heals that. I have picked up a few things along the way myself in that manner of understanding the dreams of separation, temptations of fear, loss, throwing a little persecution. Now it's your turn. Rest assured, I say this unto you, as I said this to this my beloved brother many years ago, there will be no such persecution this time.
Amen.
Yay.
Now, The other part of the message that we would share with you in this hour is given to those of you who have chosen incarnation in feminine form. Lead. Lead. We have shared this before. Important to do so again. It is vital in this turning of the age that women truly and fully lead by stepping fully into the power of the wisdom they always carry. The woman is the great carrier of the oneness with nature, with the earth. Woman is the great carrier of feeling. And it has been, shall we say, hidden, buried, suppressed, even hated, jealously desired. And far too many have been still living in a frequency of fear. Far too many women are still holding on to the great gift of being a woman who can hide her light and pretend to be weak. Somebody else can. It is time for women. Women. Beautiful, precious women. You've always been carriers of the truth. You've always been a field of soul that doesn't entirely lose the remembrance of. It is time. It is absolutely essential that women lead. Rest assured, there are growing numbers of what you call men who are just waiting for women to lead. It is essential that women lead in this dimension and world because it's hard for a lot of people on your planet to trust a man. I say this simply, but there's a great depth of truth to it. Women who are in this room tonight, you are not weak and you are not small. As you step into that light, and into that frequency giving we're talking about with you tonight, you're going to find that men change their attitude. They are going to want to support you. They're going to want and will be encouraged and inspired to serve you. You might wish to teach them how to cook first. Have you ever wondered, those of you that have paid some attention to my last incarnation, and by last I don't just mean the last one and there's going to be another one, I mean my last one. Have you not ever been curious that in the end, when all had been betrayed me and left me, those are your words, that it was the women who did not depart.
Yes.
That which is called the Three Marys knew perfectly well the role of women, the great strength and the power and the necessity of the feminine current that allows the masculine to flower and fulfill its necessity. It is time, precious woman, to acknowledge that you do know. this time, precious women, to no longer tolerate an ounce of smallness in your net. Help them, inspire them, let them know that you're there with them. Encourage them. Go forth. Fulfill the role that they've been given. Build the cosmic bridge. Write the book. Do whatever it is. No more what you call here the couch potato wing. Men, the men in this room, do you not secretly long for the inspiration of the strength of woman? Speak up. Yes.
Yes.
Every man in this room has been crying out and longing for women to come and say, we know who you are. Step forward. We're with you. And well, if you don't step forward, we won't be with you.
True. That's true.
So again, men, is this not true?
Yes.
Them, inspire them, encourage them, and what? Support them.
And let them know with the feeling of your presence that you're no longer willing to settle for less.
Okay.
No longer let the men in your life settle for being less than the men God would ask them to be. Rest assured, I was once a man. Well, sometimes my mother wasn't so sure I was such a man. I know what it means as a man to recognize the great need of the feminine frequency in its strength to emanate inspiration, heart, soul, to activate the principle within the male that gets active so it can go out and fulfill its task. When I was about 21 years of age, and was being sent to many different teachers, yes, I was sent to some male teachers, but that was all preparation. My principal teachers were female. In Egypt, in what you call as the Palestine, in Persia, and in India, my principal teachers were women. And it is not by accident that when it was time for me to fulfill the role I had been given, to demonstrate the unreality of death, the power of forgiveness and love, worst possible conditions, so rest assured the worst has already happened. It is not by accident that one was sent to me and I to her who fulfilled exactly this role. I think most of you know who I'm talking about.
Yes.
There is a soul. There is a soul of such extraordinary power. A power that comes from a love that is unshakable, eternal, vast, its vision, its truth, its patience, its love. There has never been a moment that I have ceased in what you might call bowing down before my great friend, love. Quite true. There could not have been a completion of what I brought forth to completion in that incarnation without her equal participation and presence. You have an interesting phrase, and I love your English language. so I will use some of it. In regard to Mary Magdalene, I owe her big time. Not sure what that means. The last thing she wants is more time. So this is your role, women. To remember that you are the strength. You are the power. The divine feminine is the root foundational frequency that emanates from the unknown mystery of God first. It is the womb from which all else arises. Those of you that have chosen incarnation in feminine form have done so deliberately to bring forth that current and that knowledge yet again, to ground it, to be that strength, yet a strength that is in great softness, great compassion, great care, great forgiveness, great knowing. Women, please, fulfill your role. And by the way, if the men that are sent unto you or who you find yourself partnered with or with in your current life, lest they need be reminded, let them know, because you are awake, you don't need them. And they will be given your light and your love and your presence and your encouragement and your very presence as they show and demonstrate their willingness to step forward and take up the task before them. Does that make sense for you?
Yes.
This is the great marriage of the divine masculine and the divine feminine. But in your language, we would share with you, we have not said this through this form before, the divine feminine comes first. The divine births the infinite womb of potentiality, that which holds all things, that in which all things rest and reside, the unshakable love of God. There is a skirt. This feminine in nature, that comes first. Thus, in your time frame, in the Great Atonement, it is thus necessary to demonstrate this by showing it operating through those in feminine. Does that make sense for you? Rest assured, there are many men who will flock to you. But finally, not to take, but to support. Because they will feel their own beings being touched by the power and inspiration of your strength and your love and your infinite. Not want from you the body. You're free to give it to them. They will not want from you to be submissive. They will want from you what you're already giving them, the light that inspires them to flower the magnificence of their own masculinity. So what I would ask of you, is all that has been shared this evening that clear for you?
Yes. Yes.
Thank God. Now, my brother and I can return and retire the cosmic pool and order a drink. Which, of course, we won't do. Question for you. Would you like to guess what it is?
is to be completed within us now and be the presence of love. Christ. Right now.
Remember this question and ask it of yourself without ceasing. As you walk upon your precious earth, as you go to your coffee shop, or I suppose you shop for coffee, when you go, will I now allow this great turning to be completed in me? Keep the question alive in your being. A reason for it. That reason will become clear for you as you live in that question. And you will find that the question itself activates you, awakens your desire to breathe those frequencies into the matrix of humanity. The simple asking of the question will, what is your word, galvanize you to that desire. Does that make sense for you?
Yes.
Let it come to the place where it is the only question that remains in your mind. You know some of those other questions? Why will my twin flame show up? What are the winning lottery numbers?
That's a good question.
Those are useless.
I know.
Let all questions from this moment be replaced with only that question, and you will find the doorway through the eye of the needle. Am I willing to allow this great turning to be completed in me now? You will feel this desire being birthed in you in that very moment. You will remember why you have come, and you will set about to have a ball, choosing the frequency through that desire to emanate into the matrix of humanity. And rest assured that those who need to come and be with you physically in form need to do so, they will not be able to stop themselves from being picked up on the cosmic grace carpet and whooshed into your presence. Several of you, within the next 8 to 10 months, are going to find yourself quickened into new forms of teaching, brand new forms of teaching. Some of you that have not been what you call teachers or healers are going to find that you cannot stop it now. Some of you are going to be what you call the, I won't say moving house, because you won't be taking it with you. Your baggage in your old house. Some of you are going to be moving, some of you, three of you, are going to be moving great distances. Well, what you call great distance, it's a small planet. Much change is going to now begin to be quickened within all of those that are present in this room. And with this, we return to where we began. You are here because of your compassion. You have all completed all that you need to know about the suffering of separation. It is finished. There is nothing left for you to do but to join into this great. Rest assured, in what you call your future time, there's going to be some interesting merging of the work of, once again, not really, Germaine. And myself and others. There are going to be other gatherings similar to this in which we both show up. Well, it's not that we don't show up, but in a way that can be seen and demonstrated. In other words, our working together behind the scenes is going to come to be more and more working together in front of the scenes. space that you're in right now. Look at those you are with. The day and the hour was already written and chosen. This is the turning of the age. What then could you possibly do with this great recognition except hug each other, cry, laugh, dance, sing, play, and enjoy the great frequencies of ecstasy? By the way, yes, it is true, I hear your thought. There are a few of you that are going to be leaving the planet within the next 18 months. Just two. Some of you stopped breathing. What amazing changes you are about to see begin to happen at our time. And so with that, indeed, beloved friends, we bring this hour to a close. Know that you are loved. Know that we are with you. Know that you are the great light that lights this world. Know that you are the big bringers of this light divine. Know that you have completed your task. It's time to celebrate the love that you are. Welcome them this night before you close the eyes of the body. Welcome all beings who are waiting to be sent. Welcome them to you, love of Christ. And enjoy your sleep. Peace then.